breaking news tonight. Saudi Arabia now confirming officially, publicly, the death of the dissident journalist and Washington Post contributor Jamal Khashoggi. Let's get some reaction. Democratic Senator Richard Blumenthal of Connecticut is joining us. He's a member of the Judiciary Committee. Thank you so much, Senator, for joining us. As you know, the Saudis are now dismissing two high-ranking officials. They say they've detained or arrested 18 other Saudi officials. You think that's enough? Does that satisfy you that they are at least taking some responsibility for the death of this journalist?
The Saudis very clearly seem to be buying time and buying cover. But this action raises more questions than it answers. And there's no way the world will wait for 30 days for a Saudi investigation to be done. There has to be an international investigation. It has to be done with legitimate and credible means, involving the United States, and it has to use those tapes, the surveillance that evidently the Turks have done, that show, in fact, torture, cutting of fingers, the idea that there was some botched interrogation or rogue killers or a fist fight that's responsible for the absolutely gruesome, brutal death of this American journalist, even though he's not an American citizen, a resident of the United States, is absolutely unacceptable.
Because when you compare the gruesome details that we've learned over these past couple of weeks and what the Saudis are now saying, that there was a fist fight, some sort of altercation, and he wound up dead, does that make any sense to you at all, that the 60-year-old journalist would wind up in a fist fight inside the Saudi consulate in Istanbul with 15 Saudis, high-ranking Saudi officials surrounding him, and all of a sudden he's dead?
That explanation absolutely defies credibility. We have no way of knowing at this point exactly what happened to Jamal Khashoggi, but the world deserves an explanation, not from the Saudis, who evidently are making every effort to insulate and shield the crown prince, but from an international inquiry. And this idea that they are going to arrest a certain number of the key people involved raises the possibility that they may put them in a kind of protective custody and insulate them from an international investigation, shield them from fact-finding that the world needs to do. The Saudis, for too long, have been given a pass in killing innocent civilians in Yemen, in suppressing dissent in their own country, in imprisoning women activists, and other kinds of suppression of human rights and liberties. And they evidently have underestimated the level of outrage that the world now feels.
Senator Blumenthal, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
All right, I want to go back to Sam Kiley, our international correspondent, who's in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia right now. You're working your sources. Sam, what else are you learning?
Well, we now know from none other than the Saudi press agency, Wolf, that what the future of the Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman is, and that is to head up, I say again, to head up the investigative committee that will include the Interior Minister and the Foreign Minister, among others, that will be looking into and investigating what occurred in this consulate. He is going to be investigating the very people who've been arrested, who come from very close to his own entourage, notably Saud Qatani, one of his chief media advisor, the deputy head of general intelligence, and others, bodyguards too. So he is being put in charge of the investigation into the murder of the Washington Post columnist Jamal Khashoggi, Wolf.
Because 18 Saudi nationals have now been detained. They've been arrested. They're being held right now. But two very high-ranking Saudi officials, General Ahmed Al-Asiri and Saad Al-Qahtani, both very, very close to the Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, they have been relieved of their responsibilities. Does anybody really believe they would have been involved in an operation like this to go ahead and deal with Jamal Khashoggi without the specific knowledge of and approval of the Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman?
Well, I think that's the narrative that the House of Saud has to put out. It's the narrative, Wolf, that we've been hearing from sources that was likely to be put out. But it would be it's a question of mathematics. If you look at this number of people that have been arrested, detained or relieved of their positions, the majority work for the Crown Prince in some capacity or other. And those that don't were clearly ordered in to participate in this murder, as we now know it to be, by somebody in a very senior position, notably the very senior pathologist, a professor of pathology, who was brought in as part, allegedly, of this plot. He was not part of the entourage, but you don't get somebody like that to join a team unless you've got some pretty substantial top cover, Wolf.
And you don't bring in a bone saw into an operation like this unless you have a specific goal in mind. Sam, I know you're working your sources. We're going to get back to you. Sam Kiley is in Riyadh for us. We're going to have much more on the breaking news. Our experts are standing by to assess this information. We'll be right back.